What is Armani's advice for newer devs getting into Web3 and Solana? Like, it's just, what is the short and sweet advice that you would have for anybody coming into this space right now that's looking to get involved and build?
Go to events, talk to people, contribute to open source. As a total aside, all of our hires basically came through open source, but our last one in particular is really unique because he just kept opening up PR as a backpack, and me and Tom, one of the other engineers on our team, were like, who the heck is this guy, right? He's like amazing. He's just like random. There's like no help. We gave him zero help. He just started like contributing code. And you know, we called him, and within 24 hours, we gave him an offer.
So you just saw my manager talk about me on a podcast around how I got into my current company. On this channel, I've been super transparent around how I became a remote software developer, how I made my first 15 to 30 lakh rupees on Upwork, how I got my first 100K offer right after that, how I transitioned from the 100K offer to the 500K offer. And then in September last year is when I left my 500K offer and joined this company. The story is extremely intriguing because I was supposed to join a different company, but around the same time, this company open sourced their code and a few things happened there that led me to finally join this company. In this video, I'll be sharing all the tips and tricks that are needed for you to become a remote software developer through open source, and more specifically, my journey into this company around how I started contributing, what are the hurdles I faced, how I couldn't get in from various places I tried to contact with, and finally got in because I contributed to open source. With that, let's get right into the video. So rewinding the clock back around 6 months, I was in my 4CR offer that I've talked a lot about on this channel. I wanted to transition to Web3. I had made a video series on Web3 and started to learn about it, but around September of last year is when my 1 year ended in that company. So my cliff was over. I was ready to leave the company and jump ship. And I was also very excited to join a Web3 company. I started interviewing, and up until this point, I've only done traditional interviews, which means I've gone through a round or two where people have evaluated me on my skills. And then finally I got a yes or a no. Most of the times I've seen, whenever I get an interview in a remote company, the interview is the most difficult part. Whenever I got an interview, I usually got into the company. At least that was my experience up until this point. Now in September, I was interviewing a little bit and I got into one Web3 company. They were offering a lot of money and it was a decent offer for me to switch from this company to the next one. So I told them yes and resigned from my current company, the 4CR company. And then I had a 1 month cool off period, or what you call as the resignation period, where I was basically fiddling out here and there and seeing if I can find more offers or if I can just find better companies to work with. Backpack, the company that I'm currently working at, was closed source up until this point, and hence there was no way for me to contribute to it. But around 1st October, Backpack went open source. I saw this as the right opportunity because this was a very big startup that everyone around me was talking about. They had recently raised $20 million in their seed round, which is a pretty big deal. And also the founder, Armani, the person that you saw in the beginning of this video, was the author of a very famous framework on Solana that I also read back in the day and also created some videos around. And I personally always prefer mentorship over any sort of money that you can make. This was sort of a dream offer for me, but it was very difficult for me to get in. In fact, I will show you in a few minutes how I had reached out to Armani a few months ago and did not receive any reply because, of course, he's too busy to reply to everyone who messages him or DMs him on Twitter. So 1st of October, I see Backpack is open source, and that was my window of opportunity. I had 15 more days before I was supposed to join the other company. So I knew in this 15 days, I have to contribute really heavily. Now, I was already on my notice period, but I was still working at the other company. So it was really hard. I was actually putting in 8-hour workdays at my original company. Just giving KTs, not working really hard, but KTs stand for knowledge transfers. So I was knowledge transferring everything I had gained in the last 1 year in my resigned company. And I was actively contributing to Backpack. Now, let's go through a bunch of my contributions and I'll just try to share. There's nothing like really out of the ordinary that I did. Only my frequency was really high and I understood everything without asking too many questions. I think these are the two important things when you're applying. So let's dive right into my GitHub. As you can see, I have made the biggest green on my contribution graph is around this time, which is when I started contributing to Backpack. This is around the time when I resigned and I was supposed to join the other company around 15 November. So basically I had this window to contribute to Backpack and then go over negotiations, other sort of interviews. So the timeline was really tight, and the only thing to do then was just start contributing really actively. So if you go here, you'll see most of my contributions are in Backpack. In fact, let's go to the Backpack repository. It's completely open source. Let's go back to all my contributions from October. Again, the dumb way of doing this is if I keep on clicking older here, but if you've seen the LinkedIn video, the better way of doing this is just changing this parameter here. Let's make it 300 and I'm still have a little bit to go. I'm basically going to my oldest contribution here. Let's do 450. 450 is empty, so all the algorithmic people on the channel, this is what I'm doing here is called binary search. But anyways, I've reached the oldest contribution that I made. So the first contribution I made was on September 30th. I think Backpack open sourced on 28th or 29th of September. It's a fairly simple contribution, I think. And I want to share a few things here. As you can see, the PR does not have a very big description, but that's because it's a very simple issue and it does have screenshots. If you contribute to Backpack or any other open source project today, make sure you have some screenshots or video in there. So this was my first contribution. As you can see, it wasn't even the best. Like someone found a small bug there and I had to fix it. So it was not like I was hitting the ground running from the beginning. I was also trying to make my way through. My first contribution was decent. There are a bunch of small contributions. The only thing that you should look at is the frequency at which I was committing. There were 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 contributions in a single day. Then I don't know why I took this break. I think this was the one that caught the eye of all the contributors. And again, like you don't get the appreciation you deserve when you're contributing to open source. Everyone's really busy. So everyone won't be telling you that they love that you're contributing, but they genuinely do. Like it's always good to offload, especially big tasks to other people because everyone's so busy on a day-to-day basis. And I think this was one that was fairly big and then no one else in the team was picking up. So I just picked it up and it was like a very long discussion of things that happened, but a bunch of hearts, things like these. So that might be my heart, but 4 hearts here. So like this was one that people liked. A heart, if you get a heart on an open source contribution, it means you've helped them out. If someone took 2 seconds to heart your PR, I think it's a big thing. So I kept on continuing on this one and then finally got merged on, what date was this? 11th of October. And I think it was around this time that there was some talk in the Backpack team, I think, that who's this guy who's contributing so heavily to Backpack. And a few good things that I did was I did not ask for any help. I did not ask any doubts. Even the Backpack repo, like no doubts related to the repo, how code was written. And initially the code was like, in startups, code isn't the best, but I still was able to find my way around it and do everything independently. This is a very strong point when you're trying to contribute because no one has the time to explain code bases in startups. So it's all out there. And usually there are readmes. So you have to figure your way out throughout it. And that's what I did. And it was around this time I felt fairly confident that I've made a decent bunch of contributions. My GSOC brain kicked in. I thought I've made 10 contributions. They'll probably take me or at least give me an interview. So this was the time that I got hit really bad. I reached out to a friend, a person, someone in the crypto community. I may or may not name him after I talked to him. No hate against them. The whole point was that I knew that they were in touch with the Backpack team. And hence I just asked them, hey, I've been contributing actively to Backpack. Could you connect me to someone from their team if they're hiring? Very simple, very basic. And they said, hey, that's sick, man. Nicely done. But don't think they're currently hiring, unfortunately. I totally understand this response. I have been reached out in the past and then I'm usually not able to connect people from point A to point B unless I'm very confident in their skills. And the person I was talking to here maybe wasn't really as confident in my skills and thought I've done like some random contributions and did not want to connect me to Backpack, which is totally fair. The interesting story is after this, our conversation after I actually got in. But yeah, at this point, he told me that he can't connect me and he was probably the only source for me to get in because as you will see very soon, let me just show you actually. After I talked to this person in like 2 hours, randomly, Armani reached out, Armani being the person you saw in the initial part of the video. He reached out to me on Twitter and our Twitter conversation is actually pretty interesting. It's interesting because as you can see on August 18th, I reached out to Armani and there was literally no response because probably he has a lot of DMs. And the better thing here is my GitHub had no Twitter profile, no email, literally nothing for people to reach out to me. And then after contributing for 10 days, I realized I should probably put something there and I put my Twitter on my GitHub. And that's how I think Armani got to me. Otherwise, there was literally no way for him to reach me, probably other than just commenting on GitHub for them to reach out to me. But piece of advice, keep some social handle on GitHub so that people can reach out to you. So I put my Twitter there and in a day, Armani reached out. As you can see, August 18th, no reply, but August 6th, reach out, which is a big thing. If someone reaches out to you, it's a big sign, especially if it's the CEO of the company. So here he said, hey, just wanted to reach out and say the thank you for all your Backpack contributions. My phone buzzed when I saw this Twitter message and Armani followed me right there and there as well. So I sort of knew some good things are happening from here. I wasn't sure if I'll get in, but at least I knew I'll get a conversation or an interview around this. And this was super important because there were 10 days left before I was supposed to join the other company. So I was happy. But then yet, the story hasn't ended yet. He's just reached out. So from here, I told him, thanks for reaching out and thank you for open sourcing the project because there was literally no way for me to get into Backpack if the code wasn't open source. As you can see, I tried to reach out. He He didn't reply. And if the code wasn't open source, there was basically no way for me to show my skills. But the day Backpack open sourced, the next day I started contributing. And in that window of 15 days, I at least got a reach out back, which was never possible if the project wasn't open source. Now, he basically said, would love to hop on a chat if you're interested. And I said, yes, I'm interested. And then from there, it was basically us talking very candidly around the experience that I had, the previous company that I was with, and what I was looking for in my next role. I had no formal interview. I pretty much like contributed a lot to the repo. So I had an interview with Armani, a few other members of the team, and then finally within 24 hours got the offer. So, and like I pretty much decided to join the company. I told the other company I had an offer from No for now, and I've been super happy since. So the point of this video being, there was, oh yeah, of course, there's an interesting point I forgot to share. I talked to this person, they said they couldn't connect me, but then eventually, hey, I have a small win to share. Armani ended up reaching out, surprisingly, 2 hours after I messaged you, and I'm joining them full time on 1st of November. So this was my message to them, and they were super happy for me. Again, I don't blame them. If someone would have asked me, I probably wouldn't have connected them either. But the point here is, even if there are roadblocks, and there will be roadblocks, roadblocks here being me reaching out on Twitter in August and not reaching getting back any response, and me reaching out to this person who's so close to that team, and I've contributed as well, but I still couldn't get an interview. But if you keep contributing, eventually people will reach out. Even today, we were talking about this when I was in the US. If today someone starts contributing at a frequency which is higher than everyone or like a lot of people in the team, why would we not hire them? Like, there's no reason for us to not hire someone who's contributing more than full-time employees at the company, right? So there's always a path to contribute and get into open source companies. That's the best part about open source, I think. There are no DSA interviews. There are, especially for this company, there wasn't even a formal interview. My open source contributions were all that mattered. And not just for me, a lot of my teammates were also hired through this process of people contributing to open source and then eventually getting reached out. So this is actually a way to get into companies these days, especially more common in remote jobs, because in these remote jobs, people don't have the time to interview or like hire an HR and go through an official interview process, make people solve DSA. It's very nice if someone organically reaches out, starts contributing, and then within a month or two, or like even 15 days for me, you can basically judge their skills based on the contributions they're making, based on the questions they're asking, and based on their speed, how quickly they're able to iterate, and then decide whether or not you want to hire them. So this is an extremely important skill. The earlier you can inculcate it, the better, especially now when Google Summer of Code is just 1 month away. Even if you don't make it to GSOC, start contributing. It will come back to you in one way or the other. Worst case, you get into a remote job of like 100K, at least six figures, which is great from India. So that was my journey. I joined around 6 months ago and have been super happy since. I worked remotely for 3 months, then was in Singapore for a week to talk about Backpack, and then eventually went to the US for 2 months to work from there. So it's a very nice lifestyle. You can stay or choose to stay in India if you want, but you can also work from various offices of the company. I do think I am much happier here versus when I was doing a 9-to-5 or like going to an office in India in Bangalore. Personal choice, you can decide for your own. But if remote jobs is what you're looking for, open source contributions are what matter a lot. And the next few videos are purely going to be me contributing to open source. I know this video will get a lot of views, but I would highly appreciate if all the videos from here, especially the ones in which I'm making actual contributions, the one that will help you crack a remote job, get a lot of views as well. And you spend time or like 30 minutes to an hour that I'm spending contributing, just learning how to do it. And then maybe even contributing to Google Summer of Code this year. The key takeaways from this video are remote jobs are a real career. Open source is the best way for you to get into one, and I've basically shared the blueprint of how to do that. There is a very level playing field. Everyone is the same when contributing, and your contributions are all that matter. Your time zone does not matter, your accent does not matter, your pedigree, which college you went to, did not matter. Here, Armani did not know I went to an IIT, and it doesn't matter at all. The only thing that matters is how actively you contribute, your frequency of contributing, and the kind of questions that you're asking when you're contributing in that initial phase. So let's try to tackle that in the few upcoming videos, and hopefully many of you will reach that path, and I'd be super happy if you do. With that, as I said, I was in the US for 2 months, and that's because we have a very big event coming around 10th of April. So if you're into NFTs or understand NFTs, my company is doing a mint on 10th of April. So if you're a degen trader and you'd like to buy some NFTs, feel free to mint on around 10th of April. If you don't yet trade, I know most people here are students. You should understand the mechanics behind it, the protocol that was built. If you want to contribute to Backpack, you probably should. I've shown you the blueprint of getting hired at Backpack. So I look forward to a lot of contributions from you guys. And probably in the next video, I'll share a few tips and techniques around how you should contribute, the kind of etiquette that's expected, and the kind of things that you can do to make sure your PR gets merged quicker than everyone else. With that, this was a long video, but I'm finally happy to share my journey. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.
What was your love story with open source?
So, yeah, I mean, I think as a developer, open source is like really attractive for a lot of reasons. You could actually extract much more value from your employer if like your work is simply just open source. And the reason for that is like, you know, there's several reasons, right? And like, you know, the first reason is just like, well, you know, that code now exists. Maybe there's some favorable license that'll allow you to use it in the future. And you could always reference that stuff in the future. And so that's like maybe like the first reason. And then the second reason is like, well, you can get exposed to a lot of things that you otherwise wouldn't get exposed to, right? Whether it's people that you meet like through PRs or issues, you start like building a network, right? And that's like a really like valuable thing, I think, as a developer, because you always want to be exposed to new opportunities and learn from new people and stuff.